It's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd, and massive sunscreen nerd. And today we are talking about zinc oxide sunscreens. There are so many myths around mineral or physical sunscreens. These are the ones with zinc oxide and titanium dioxide, and how they're supposedly better than chemical sunscreens. These are the ones with scarier sounding names like oxybenzone and octocrylene. And it's usually zinc oxide that gets all of the hype. Some of these advantages are true, but so many are just myths. And a lot of these myths are being spread on social media, not just by influencers, but by sunscreen brands, doctors, dermatologists, cosmetic scientists. And I think these myths are getting people to use sunscreens that aren't necessarily the best option for them. I've talked about the pros and cons of chemical and physical sunscreens before, with things like safety and irritation and environmental impact. You can check out my other videos on those. But today I wanted to focus on the myth that zinc oxide sunscreens are actually better sunscreens, that they give better protection against UV. I was originally going to cover the other myths as well, but then this video ended up way too long, so that is future Michelle's problem. I've also probably missed a few myths, so if you can think of any more, leave them in the comments. If you like sciencey beauty content, click the like and the subscribe and the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. First off, I have nothing against people using zinc oxide sunscreens. If you prefer them, then keep using them. I just want everyone to know the real benefits and drawbacks so that you can make the best decision for your own situation. I'm going to be calling the two types of sunscreen chemical and physical in this video. It's not great terminology and it kills me a bit inside every time I use it. Organic and inorganic are far more accurate, but chemical and physical is what everyone calls them, so I'm just going to be a sheep here. Zinc oxide and titanium dioxide are physical sunscreens, everything else is chemical. So, zinc oxide being the most effective sunscreen. The most common reason I've seen for this is the myth that zinc oxide works like a shield, it reflects and scatters UV, while chemical sunscreens work like a sponge, they absorb UV. This is probably the most widespread myth about chemical and physical sunscreens, and it's not true. Just like chemical sunscreens, mineral sunscreens mostly work by absorbing UV and turning it into a tiny amount of heat. About 95% of the UV that hits a mineral sunscreen gets absorbed and turned into heat. Only about 5% gets scattered. If you want to learn more about the nitty-gritty details of how sunscreens work, I have a video on that. I'm not sure why scattering is used to make mineral sunscreens sound better. I think it's to do with how absorbing sounds bad, like it's not really getting rid of the UV, and it's not as good as like a superhero shield that darts around and bounces off the UV. I think it's also confusion around the word absorb, because it sounds like chemical sunscreens absorb into the skin, and that means that it's not really protecting the upper layers, which is also a myth. But it doesn't really matter because almost all of the UV is absorbed by the mineral sunscreen, only a tiny amount is scattered. Now, some people might cling onto that scattered 5% and still say that because of that, zinc oxide is better. But scattering isn't actually as good as it sounds. Most of the scattered UV is actually scattered forwards, so deeper towards your skin. This isn't really a problem because it increases the chance of that UV hitting another sunscreen particle and getting absorbed. But basically, absorption's actually really good because it destroys the UV and turns it into something less harmful, whereas scattering just sort of deflects the bullet. Now, this myth birthed another myth. Maybe we can start making like a sunscreen myth family tree, a cursed family tree. Mineral sunscreens are better because they don't produce heat. Well, I've already said that there's only a 5% difference in heat and 5% is tiny, but zinc loyalists might say that 5% still might matter, that heat still might contribute to pigment and melasma. So I did a test with a thermal camera and some sunscreens, and it turns out that the difference in heat is undetectable. The difference is actually smaller than the difference in heat between this part of your arm and this part of your arm. There's also the idea that mineral sunscreens, specifically zinc oxide, is broader spectrum, and so it protects against more UV wavelengths, unlike chemical sunscreens. Again, this is probably like a cousin of the shield thing, but it is partly true. Zinc oxide is a broader spectrum ingredient. It protects against UVA1, UVA2, and UVB, But not because it works like a shield. Titanium dioxide is also a mineral sunscreen, but it isn't very good at protecting against the longer wavelengths of UVA1 unless it starts going white. And there are chemical sunscreens that can protect against all three regions as well. But I guess it boils down to, does a broader spectrum sunscreen ingredient lead to a more protective sunscreen? Well, no. Broad spectrum just tells you about the breadth of protection and not the strength of protection. And the strength of protection is where zinc oxide really falls short. Sunscreen protection is a bit like a wall. Zinc oxide is a broad spectrum ingredient, so it's like a really wide wall. It protects against all the wavelengths. But it's not a very protective, strong wall. It's a bit like Swiss cheese. It's got lots of holes. So if you only have one layer of this rather holy wall, then you can still get lots of UV getting through. You can imagine UV as like balls getting thrown against this wall. A lot of balls will still go through the wall. Chemical sunscreens are like narrow walls without a lot of breadth, so they only protect a small section, but they tend to be stronger, so they have less gaps, and so they protect a small section, but they protect that small section a bit better. So right now it seems like both options aren't great, but we can improve both of them. We can stack more of these zinc oxide walls together, and so you end up with a lot more protection all along the wall. This is the equivalent of adding more zinc oxide to the sunscreen. Different chemical sunscreens protect against different parts of the UV spectrum, and so we can put up more walls on different places. We're mixing different chemical sunscreen ingredients into the one sunscreen product. Now, the problem is we can't just jam in an infinite amount of zinc oxide into a sunscreen. We need other things in the sunscreen product to help it spread out, to keep it on the skin, to stop it from feeling and looking like chalk. Chemical sunscreens are soluble, so they feel a lot better than zinc oxide. And it turns out we can mix more chemical ingredients into a sunscreen to get a higher protection than we can get if we just jam zinc oxide into a product. There's been some new developments in zinc oxide technology where you can basically get different shapes of zinc oxide particles to get higher protection. But still, the maximum you can get from a zinc oxide-only sunscreen is still around SPF 60 and UVA PF 20. With chemical sunscreens, you can get SPFs of over 100 and UVA PFs of over 60. If you look at the highest SPF-rated sunscreens, none of them use zinc oxide. They all have a mixture of chemical filters and titanium dioxide, or just chemical filters. Which is another funny part of this, titanium dioxide is actually a really efficient sunscreen ingredient. It gives much stronger protection than zinc oxide, and a lot of chemical sunscreen ingredients as well. But poor titanium dioxide gets ignored because, I don't know, zinc oxide's the golden child. But zinc oxide still doesn't protect really well in the UVA1 region, so if you want a high UVA1 sunscreen, then you kind of have to go with chemical. So the whole zinc oxide is the only FDA-approved ingredient that protects against UVA1, UVA2, and UVB. It doesn't make zinc oxide sunscreens more protective because you can mix different chemical ingredients into the one sunscreen. And that means it can block UVA1, UVA2, and UVB. It's like saying salt tastes good on its own, so plain salted food is the tastiest. Well, no, because you can mix other seasonings together. There's also the myth that zinc oxide protects against blue light. And again, it's more of that zinc oxide is like a shield that protects against everything. For a sunscreen against visible light, you need iron oxides and pigmentary titanium dioxide, which has large particles and looks white. Iron oxides absorb visible light, pigmentary titanium dioxide scatters light, so it bounces it around the sunscreen film until it has a chance to be absorbed by the iron oxides. Again, absorption is the bomb. I don't know if people still say the bomb. Tinted products like foundations, tinted moisturizers, tinted sunscreens usually have both pigmentary titanium dioxide and iron oxides, so they give the best protection. Mineral sunscreens don't absorb visible light, and they don't scatter visible light unless it's accidental. White cast is what happens when you have scattering, but mineral sunscreen ingredients are optimized to try to minimize that white cast. There is one study from Color Science where the conclusion claims that zinc oxide makes titanium dioxide and iron oxides work better. But the data they show doesn't really support this. They tested 4 products, 3 tinted sunscreens, and 1 face cream. The formula with the least mineral sunscreen ingredients and the lowest SPF actually gave the best visible light protection. So yeah, keep in mind that you can't necessarily trust the conclusions of studies, you need to read them critically. Zinc oxide is better because it works immediately. This one's a bit weird, and I think it's another bastard child of the reflect versus absorb myth. I think people got confused between absorbing UV and absorbing into skin. You might have seen this as chemical sunscreens need to absorb or react with skin to work, and so you have to apply chemical sunscreens 15 minutes before you go out into the sun, whereas physical sunscreens work immediately. These are all myths. Both types of sunscreen ingredients absorb UV straight away. You can see them absorbing UV on paper here. But both types also need about 15 minutes to spread out on your skin to form an even intact layer. So you use them the exact same way, unless it's a special formula that's designed to absorb into the skin like the Evi sunscreens, but that's a completely separate issue. Because it's more photostable and therefore you don't need to reapply. Another reason people give for zinc oxide being better is that it's more photostable, which means it doesn't break down in the sun after absorbing too much UV, whereas chemical sunscreens do. Now, some chemical sunscreens can break down in the sun, and once they've broken down, they don't work as well. But there are a lot of chemical sunscreen ingredients that are photostable. This includes most of the older sunscreen filters, plus the newer sunscreen filters that were specifically designed to be photostable. And even the less photostable chemical sunscreens can be stabilized by other things in the formula. So for example, avobenzone is pretty unstable on its own. But in Neutrogena's Helioplex formulas, it still gives more than 85% UVA protection after 5 hours of midday sun exposure. For all sunscreens, chemical and physical, you're meant to reapply every 2 hours, and that's because the sunscreen layer starts to crack and wear off, sort of like how a foundation breaks up over time. So 5 hours from Helioplex should be more than enough. There's a study that looked at how well different sunscreens absorb UV after leaving them in UV for a while. The higher the line is, the more it's protecting in that region. The top two sunscreens have avobenzone, the bottom one has zinc oxide and titanium dioxide only. You can see that none of them are changing too much after UV exposure. You can compare that with a non-photostable sunscreen like this one. Now, there are some arguments why zinc oxide can actually be less protective even with the same SPF. Reason number one is people are likely to apply less zinc oxide sunscreens. Zinc oxide sunscreens have a lot of drawbacks that are pretty obvious if you've ever tried them. They can leave a white cast, especially if you have darker skin, and sometimes it fades away, but a lot of the time it doesn't, and so you end up walking around looking like you're wearing YouTuber makeup. They usually have a pretty thick texture. Zinc oxide is an insoluble mineral, and so texture-wise, it's a lot like ground up dirt or rock. It's not great at absorbing UV, so a lot of the time in sunscreens you need 10-25%. So you can imagine if you have like a jar of moisturizer, you're adding 1-2.5 teaspoons of dirt into this. The base of the sunscreen also has to be pretty thick to keep the particles suspended and spread out, and not let them sink to the bottom for a relatively long period of time. So it's not a great setup for a product that feels nice on your skin, and they tend to clog up pores as well. They're also usually pretty drying because zinc oxide can soak up oil a bit like a clay mask. On the other hand, chemical sunscreens tend to be a lot lighter, not always, but it's a lot more doable, and they tend not to have a white cast. Now, all of this might seem superficial and not a big deal, but cosmetic elegance is important. A little doesn't go a long way with sunscreens. For a sunscreen to work, you need to be applying the right amount, which is quite a lot, and reapplying it often, and you're less likely to do that with a sunscreen that's super white and super thick. A CeraVe survey found that 55% of people who skip daily sunscreen did this because they didn't like the way it feels during and after application. 38% said that white cast was an issue. There's also a study from a sunscreen ingredient manufacturer, so flagging for possible bias, but they make both organic and inorganic sunscreen ingredients. They found that people unconsciously used 29% less of a 6% titanium dioxide sunscreen versus a sunscreen that had 3% titanium dioxide and 3% of a chemical sunscreen ingredient. You can also see a lot of reviews of zinc oxide sunscreens online where they say, "It's really thick, but a little goes a long way," which just doesn't work. The other big issue we don't really talk about much with mineral sunscreens is stability, and not photostability, but just regular stability. For a sunscreen to work well, the sunscreen ingredients have to stay spread out in the sunscreen, in the bottle during its lifetime, plus when you're applying it on your skin, plus when it's been sitting on your skin for a while. If it clumps up, then you get holes in your protection. Most chemical sunscreens are soluble, which means it's mixed at a molecular level. It's a little bit like vinegar. When you have vinegar, the vinegar molecules stay spread out in the vinegar for a really long time. They don't eventually sink to the bottom. But when you have bigger particles, it's a lot harder to keep them separated for longer. You can use a thicker texture with rheology modifiers to keep the particles further apart for longer. You can also coat the particles to try to stop them from clumping. But at the end of the day, particles are always going to be harder to stabilize than a solution or a normal emulsion. This is especially the case when you have zinc oxide and titanium dioxide. They are really dense materials, 4 to 6 times denser than water, and so gravity wants to pull them to the bottom. And it's even worse when you have uncoated zinc oxide, which a lot of natural sunscreen companies tend to use, because the coatings tend to be synthetic. Zinc oxide itself is already pretty synthetic, but they just don't use them. These uncoated particles really want to clump up a lot. So these large particles tend to clump up together and separate in the bottle if you leave it for too long, if you let it get too hot, or if you apply it to your skin and let it get wet. And I think this is the reason why a lot of mineral sunscreens, especially those from natural brands that use uncoated zinc oxide in a really oily base, tend to get really bad scores in Consumer Reports tests. They measure the SPF after something that's pretty similar to the water resistance test. They apply the sunscreen to the person, they get the person to sit in water, and then they test the SPF. And there are also lots of reviews of these sorts of products from people who got burnt while using them. And I think it's a mixture of people being more likely to underapply a really thick product and just the unstable drama queen nature of uncoated zinc oxide. But I think if you're aware of these issues, then it's fine because you can work around them. Make sure you still apply the right amount of sunscreen. Don't use it if it's expired. Don't let the bottle get too hot. Don't use it if it's separated. So at the end of the day, it's the same thing that I keep on saying. The best sunscreen is the one that you use. If it's something you enjoy, if it's something that fits in your budget, if it's something that you can easily access, if it's something that doesn't irritate your skin, then it's going to be the best sunscreen for you. It doesn't really matter if it's physical or chemical. And also remember, sunscreen is not the be-all and end-all. You can also use other sun protective measures like hats and clothing. So hopefully I've covered most of the myths about zinc oxide being more protective. If I didn't, leave me a comment with the extra myths. If you liked the video, click the like and the subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram and check out my blog. See you next time. Hopefully it's not about sunscreen again, but I can't make any promises because it is heading to sunscreen season and you are going to see myths everywhere.